Hi everyone, I'm Ruben, Zcoin's community manager, and you know, we just celebrated our 1 year anniversary. Zcoin is now 1 year old. We've grown a lot. I mean, you know, our team has expanded from a single coder on the team, which was just Poramin basically, to around like 7 developers. So we have now 3 other team members and 2 advisors, and we're still growing. So, you know, we've grown a lot, and hopefully can roll up updates a lot faster and, you know, be a more professional project. In conjunction with this anniversary, we are holding a competition for the most creative post on Twitter, the creative photo. And right now, actually, we have a bunch of really good submissions. I'm really impressed. And soon we'll be shortlisting some of our favorite ones and having a community vote to vote on the winners. We greatly appreciate your time and work in making the submissions. And remember, the first prize is 25 Zcoin, with the runner-ups earning 15 Zcoin and 10 Zcoin each. Now, a quick update on the bounty for the MTP competition. So we actually held a bounty competition whereby we invited people to look at the MTP paper and suggest ways to improve it or identify flaws in the MTP paper. And we've got a good response. We've actually gotten 2 submissions from Mark Bavan and Fabian Cohel. The Fabian Cohel's submission was actually very last minute. I think it just happened like 1 or 2 days ago. But so it's just in time for the bounty. And we have forwarded this to Dimitri and Alex, the authors of MTP, for classification and evaluation. And as soon as we can classify and verify it, we'll be honoring the bounty. Just a reminder, the bounty was 12,500 USD, 10,000 USD being for identifying problems with the MTP paper itself, and 2,500 USD for our own implementation. So we, you know, Mark Bavan and Fabian Cohel will probably getting be some share of this, and we'll be publishing the full breakdown as soon as we can. We really are grateful for their submissions, and we hope that these developments can also assist Alex and Dimitri in revising MTP so that we can update our code as well. So we'll keep you. I know everyone's like been waiting for updates on MTP. But these things do take time, so just stay tuned. As soon as we have an update from then, the new paper is out, we'll give you some time estimates. Now, we are actually still experiencing some transition issues from the old core from 0.8 to 0.13, and we are still working hard to fix them. For the moment, if you're going to be doing any Zcoin transactions, make sure to have a backup of your wallet.dat. You can do that by going to File, Backup, Wallet. You know, just save it in a different location, and you have a backup before you do any mint or any spend, so that you can restore your wallet if for whatever reason it doesn't go through. We know this isn't ideal, but you know, give us a bit of time, and you can check through our GitHub. That we've been working really furiously to push out fixes to this. So thank you for your patience. We hope to get someone, you know, to do some quality assurance and testing in the future as soon as possible, because right now we don't have a professional software tester that results in a lot of these H cases popping up in real life. The latest version that at the date of this video is 0.13.2.5 release candidate 3, which is available on our GitHub page and also on the main website. We probably have a few more versions to go until the latest one, but you know, do update to the latest available version as soon as you can, because it actually does help to stabilize the network. It still boils down to a lot of incompatibility between 0.8 to 0.13. As mentioned previously, I think a lot of you have heard that you know, we were considering launching our own mining pool, and we finally made a decision on this. And Poramin is working this weekend to launch our own mining pool to help stabilize and spread out the hash rate. This allows us to rapidly deploy new updates to the, you know, to the mining pools. And we'll probably start with a 0% fee to begin with to attract miners, and up the fee later, you know, once we want to achieve sort of a, you know, a fair share among the other pools as well. We hope to have it sometime up later this week, and fingers crossed, we'll bring much needed stability to the network. And you know, actually, in retrospect, even if the upgrade from 0.8 to 0.13 was supposed to be a soft fork, it might have been actually better to do it in a hard fork. But never mind, we know we're moving through it. And the good thing is that they have new pools, two new pools that have launched, or rather, Z pools reactivated the pool and found their first block recently. So you know, I think I managed to convince them to down their fee from 2% to 1%. And so you know, it's worth mining on them. And also, there's another one called Flappy Pool as well, which I think just recently launched. I haven't given them a try, but yeah, you know, please do try to spread out your hash rate just rather than just mining at Mining Pool Hub. Speaking of mining, some of our community members actually noticed that someone, those using tprovot ccminer, was experiencing some loss of hash rate from the reported pool. And this led to some people claiming that Mining Pool Hub was stealing hash rate. But we actually investigated into this, and it actually appears to be a particular issue with ccminer when using tprovot's version. Now we verified this because this problem doesn't actually occur on xchanges that's used for AMD cards. So it only happens when you use tprovot's version of ccminer. And we actually managed to find that it was a particular piece of code which was causing you know, shares to be rejected on both Supernova and Mining Pool Hub. I think we'd like to thank CKR Isil, I'm not sure how to pronounce that, for identifying this. And I just spoke to DGM, and he confirms that this is a known issue, a known issue with tprovot's miner, and the code does indeed affect many coins as well, not just us. So the next version that DGM will be pushing out will disable this code in tprovot, but you know, push all the latest updates, so you should be getting an improved hash rate there and more stable mining results that is more reflective on the pool. Now, the updates to the Zcoin library, libzerocoin, have been completed on the old core and tested. A porting work we hope to complete next week. I know we did promise sometime this week. Some delays because we were resolving the transition from the old core to the new core. But this isn't too difficult a job, and hopefully it should be completed this week. Then we can announce the fork to enable these improvements to Zcoin. Our revamp website is also going through final touches and aiming to complete sometime this coming week as well. An update on marketing: we have been in talks with a company called Naga DDB, a professional and actually very well-known creative agency in the region, working with us on coming up with a, you know, rebranding. Well, branding as I not necessarily rebranding, but it's more of like giving, you know, Zcoin a proper story, a way to communicate our benefits to, you know, regular people. Because one of the primary complaints of Zcoin has that, you know, despite our tech, despite our team, it's been hard to communicate our message and vision, as we've been a bit geeky and technical on that. So we hope to have another DDB to help us come up with some quality materials that more people can get behind. We haven't confirmed anything with them yet. They are obviously, you know, not that cheap. So we have to manage our costs, but we're organizing another brainstorm meeting this Monday, and they're actually very excited to work with us. So hopefully can probably give them a go and see how it goes. We'll keep you posted on that. Also, since the last update, we got listed on two exchanges, which was Bitcoin Indonesia and Coinroom. And you know, Bitcoin Indonesia in particular has been really amazing, with his volume topping Bitrex on some days. You know, that's really impressive. And we'll be making a trip down to Indonesia soon. Terima kasih semua orang. And we're still working on having more exchanges, but right now we are just focusing on making sure our core and you know, our wallet is totally stable before we want to launch on more pools. I know some of you have been talking about TDEX. You know, we're thinking about middle of October, but you know, let's see how fast we can get the core upgrade completely stable on that. On the Zcoin Mixer on Ethereum, Rodan has actually made some interesting suggestions in reducing the gas cost through the use of oracles. the ideas of oracles are to offload the computation off-chain, but only have the chain verify that the work is done correctly, so that you don't have to be worried about the oracle cheating. This idea actually makes this Ethereum mixer, a zero coin mixer, much more cost effective. So we're really excited about that, and hopefully we can get something out really soon. We have some really cool ideas in utilizing the Znodes network to work with this. Still in the concept stage, so we don't want to announce too much, but we'll share when we have something more concrete. On the user interface side, we have now a professional UX designer joining us on the 2nd of October to help us work on it. If you have any suggestions on what you'd like to see, let us know. You know, reach out to us on Slack or just drop an email to us. We're particularly focusing on the usability of the zero coin portions of the wallet, but hopefully we just have a nice wallet to use. And don't worry about Znodes, we haven't forgotten about you. We'll keep you posted as soon as we have anything to update. Again, for those of you who aren't aware, provided that we can get this core upgrade down stably, Znodes should be done in approximately 6 weeks-ish, give or take. But take this as a rough estimate, and don't be too hard on us. The amount of Zcoin needed for a Znode is still being discussed. I did mention earlier that it should be in the 3-digit range to the low thousands. So, you can consider that when you're acquiring your Zcoins. We'll keep you posted as usual. I mean, we haven't made any final decision on that, but that's the current situation on Znodes at the moment. So that's all we have to update this week. Thanks everyone, and have a good weekend.